Good morning and welcome. We would also like to welcome all the visitors that we might have with us today. Today we celebrate the second Sunday of Advent. Our entrance hymn can be found in the Glory and Praise Book, number 296, on Jordan's Bank, number 296. We'd also like to welcome all the listeners that we have with us as well today.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In order to more worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, and a spirit of wisdom and of understanding, a spirit of counsel and of strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord, and his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Not by appearance shall he judge, nor by hearsay shall he decide, but he shall judge the poor with justice and decide aright for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Justice shall be banned against his waist, and faithfulness a belt upon his hips. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the child. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, and the little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall be neighbors, together their young shall rest. The lion shall eat hay like the ox. The baby shall play by the cobra's den, and the child lay his hand on the adder's lair. There shall be no harm or ruin on all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with knowledge of the Lord, as waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse, set up as a signal for the nations, the Gentiles shall seek out, for his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, whatever was written previously was written for our instruction, that by endurance and by the encouragement of the scriptures we might have hope. May the God of endurance and encouragement grant you to think in harmony with one another, in keeping with Christ Jesus, that with one accord you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, then, as Christ welcomed you to the glory of God. For I say that Christ became a minister of the circumcised to show God's truthfulness, to confirm the promises to the patriarchs, but so that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy. As it is written, therefore, I will praise you among the Gentiles and sing praises to your name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. John the Baptist appeared, preaching in the desert of Judea, and saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." It was of him that the prophet Isaiah had spoken when he said, "A voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths.'" John wore clothing made of camel's hair and had a leather belt around his waist. His food was locust and wild honey. At that time, Jerusalem, all Judea, and the whole region around the Jordan were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. When he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming to his baptism, he said to them, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the coming wrath? Produce good fruit as evidence of your repentance. And do not presume to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our father.' For I tell you, God can raise up children to Abraham from these stones. Even now the axe lies at the root of the trees. Therefore, every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I am baptizing you with water for repentance. But the one who is coming after me is mightier than I. I am not worthy to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand. He will clear his threshing floor and gather his wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
John the Baptist stands as a great figure and a great model of preparation. In the season of Advent, now as we begin our second week, we begin to feel an urgency in preparing our hearts for the coming of Christ at Christmas. And we have this great account of John the Baptist as he's baptizing and confronting the Pharisees, and he has very clear words about those that don't take this time of preparation seriously. So, St. John is a great example for us, because that urgency should be something that's present in our heart right now. This week I was decorating the rectory. I'm one of those people that likes to decorate early. I don't know, mainly because you run out of time. December goes very quickly. So as I was putting up the tree and hanging my little Hallmark ornaments and putting, you know, the stuff around the house that my mother tells me I have to put up, doing all those things, I was thinking about, actually, this gospel passage, about those who don't take the time to prepare their hearts as much as they do our homes. Because we are very busy with the preparations for the Christmas season with our families and buying presents and decorating our house and thinking of what we're going to cook, and those are all good things. Those are all very good things. But sometimes in the busyness of the preparation for the season and for those fun and good times with family, we neglect to take a little bit of time for us to be with the Lord. And perhaps that's the lesson St. John gives us, is that in the midst of all the good things we're doing to prepare for Christmas, to prepare our homes, let us take some time aside to be present with the one who we are preparing to welcome. So perhaps the gift that we can give ourselves this season is that time in the quiet, that time away from the busyness of the world, to sit with Christ and ask him to take whatever in our heart needs to be transformed. Whatever in our heart needs to be taken away, to surrender whatever it is that holds us back from fully entering into these great mysteries, which in 2 weeks' time we will celebrate. Let us ask for that grace to have that urgency that St. John the Baptist was preaching about today in the gospel, and that we'll be as urgent in our preparations of our heart and our spiritual preparations as we are about all the things in our home and with our families. Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made.
Surrender for our salvation, he came down from heaven, by the Holy Spirit, and he came to heaven.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Confident in our Father's love and mercy, we offer to him now our needs and our prayers.
We pray that all nations may welcome the Lord at his coming. May all people turn from error and sin, open their hearts to Jesus Christ, and prepare to see him face to face in the final judgment. We pray to the Lord. That Catholics foster the virtues of prudence, fortitude, justice, and temperance, serve as examples of natural goodness, and live happy and balanced lives. We pray to the Lord. We remember those who are often forgotten in society, the poor, homeless, and unemployed. May they receive the earthly blessings they need to do your will. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who are physically or mentally disabled. May their lives be experiences of grace, and may they be able to serve the Lord according to their gifts. We pray to the Lord. As we prepare to celebrate the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem, we pray for the Christians living in the Holy Land. May they remain faithful despite oppression and continue to be examples of peace. We pray to the Lord. And for all those personal prayers and intentions we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious God, we, your children, entrust to you these our needs. Draw near to us now and answer these prayers which we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As our gifts are prepared, please join in singing from the Glory and Praise Book, number 433. Holy is his name, number 433.
I'm
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving and passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Genevieve, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, and the power, and the glory are yours, and now forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song can once again be found in the Glory and Praise book. Number 550, Servant Song, number 550.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We have the following announcements. In your kindness, please pray for the repose of the soul of Charles Walton and Rosella Gettinger, whose funeral masses were this past week. Congratulations to Christian Wyatt, son of Christopher and Melissa, and congratulations to Brentley Black, son of Cheyenne, who were baptized this past week. A recessional hymn is again in the Glory and Praise Book, number 425, Hail Holy Queen, verses 1 and 5.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.